Hey there, everyone. It's Tuesday, September 21st, 2021. Let's begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Listen to my prayer, O God. Do not ignore my plea. Hear me and answer me. Evening, morning, and noon, I cry out in distress, and He hears my voice. Cast your care on the Lord, and He will sustain you. He will never let the righteous fall. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. So we're at the psalm reading for this coming Sunday. It's from Psalm 104. It's the last section of it, 27 verses 27 to 35. The title in the ESV translation for the section is, O Lord, my God, you are very great. So it's a song of confidence. It's a psalm of praise, and that's exactly what we'll see as we read through this, especially praising God for his revelation through creation itself. Verse 27, let's start. These all look to you to give them their food in due season. In other words, everything depends on God. This is part of in your catechism, Luther's evening or a meal prayer says, the eyes of all look to you, O Lord, and you give them their food in due season. So that's where this comes from. Verse 28, when you give it to them, they gather it up. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things. When you hide your face, right, that's a bad thing here. God turning away from his creation, turning away from us is a bad thing. When you hide your face, they are dismayed. When you take away their breath, they die and return to their dust. Now, of course, that takes you back to creation, right? How did God create Adam? He formed him out of the dust, and then he breathed into them. So as God turns his back on us, we return to dust, right? Think of Ash Wednesday, from dust you are, and to dust you shall return. Verse 30. Now, and this is right. This is for all creation, all living beings. That's for every generation, including you and me today. Verse 30. When you sent forth your spirit, they are created. And you renew the face of the ground. This is generation to generation since Adam. Verse 31, may the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. Now the psalmist kind of turns now and is praying that creation, ever since Genesis 1, would continue to show God's glory. And it does, right? Yet God's power is beyond creation. I'll start again with verse 31. Excuse me. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. Who looks on the earth and it trembles. Who touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God while I have being. May my meditation be pleasing to him, for I rejoice in the Lord. Now that meditation term there, we're not talking some sort of Middle East or Far Eastern meditation here. We're talking about when I focus on God's thoughts. When I focus my thoughts on him, that's what my meditation is. And we're never done, right? The depths and the riches of God, we're never done thinking about and meditating and reading, marking, and learning, and inwardly digesting God's word. He continues, for I rejoice in the Lord. And then finally, verse 35, let sinners be consumed from the earth. And let the wicked be no more. Kind of a somber turn here at this end of the song of praise. But it's a recognition that sin needs to be eradicated for that new creation when Christ comes again. And only when that sin is dealt with can there be praise? So bless the Lord, O my soul, praise the Lord. My dear friends, sin has been consumed. It was consumed on a Friday outside Jerusalem, a little over 2,000 years ago in Jesus Christ. Your sin, my sin, the sin of all creation was consumed in Christ's death and resurrection. So now our souls can sing. We can bless the Lord and we can sing his praises today. And we can look forward to that day when there will be no more sin in the new creation. Until then, we trust in him to open his hands and satisfy the desires of us and every living thing. Let's continue. O Lord, have mercy upon us. O Christ, have mercy upon us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Heavenly Father, send your Holy Spirit into our hearts, to direct and rule us according to your will, to comfort us in all our afflictions, to defend us from all error, and to lead us into all truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God, and have a great day.